Looking at the Arduino, there is a USB-B port, and then that USB-B port is connected to the PC via a USB-A cable. Then you can communicate via serial between Arduino and PC. And I mentioned that the USB port is connected to pins 0 and 1. So generally, in the case of the Arduino Uno, there is one serial communication port that can communicate with a PC, and it has one hardware serial communication port. However, in the case of the Mega, there are a total of 4 ports available for serial communication, including USB. TX0 and RX0 are the serial ports connected to the USB. And then there are 3 additional serial ports labeled from TX1 to TX3. However, for this session, I will explain based on the Arduino Uno. When setting up serial communication, the first thing to do is to input begin and set the baud rate you want to communicate with. Generally, 9600 or 1150-200 is commonly used. So I will input 9600 here. This will attempt to connect to the PC based on this baud rate. Typically, you would just input this and immediately start entering commands related to serial communication. But it is better to wait until the connection is properly established. To wait, you can use a while loop with serial. And when the serial communication is ready, it becomes true. If it is not ready, it remains false. So, if it is not ready, it will enter the infinite loop. Wait until the serial communication is ready, and then proceed with serial. Once everything is ready and connected, I will send a message saying hello world from the Arduino side to the PC side. After entering the text hello world into the input field and uploading it, you will then see the serial monitor. Displayed at the top right corner of the screen right here, this process is essential for verifying that your input has been successfully uploaded and is now visible on the monitor. If you click on the magnifying glass icon, you will see that when it booted up, hello world was overlapping with the text in front. Please clear it and try Arduino again. When you reboot, you can see text like hello world appearing. If the baud rate is not correct, the text will be garbled. So if the text appears garbled in the serial monitor, please check if the baud rate setting is definitely correct. I set it to 9600, and in my case I used serial.print, but there is also println. The difference is that if I send 3 of these, for example, such as hello, world, and test. Moreover, you can also use other baud rates if needed. For instance, you might choose 1150, 200, or 4800, depending on your requirements. Then, after simply uploading, you can see that everything is just on one line. But if I just simply actually input ln and upload 3, then even now, the last carriage return that breaks the line is added, so the things being sent are marked to indicate a line break. Additionally, when you want to check the time zone of many data exchanges during serial communication, there is a timestamp display at the bottom left. If you enable this and press it again, you can see the order of the timestamps, indicating when the data was received. I will turn this off again here. Turning it off. Next, just because we send a command doesn't mean that the data used here will actually be the data used. The data does not go directly to the other side, the PC side. There is an additional buffer used for sending, and every time the environment allows, the data is sent using that buffer. So when I want to ensure that all the data I send from here has been completely transmitted, and then I want to enter the desired command, I do it after confirming that. When you flush the serial, this command waits until the sending byte buffer is completely empty. What I mean by waiting is that it's not just about waiting completely. In fact, there can be empty spaces or gaps in the buffer. In this case, you would typically use a while serial. This is four. This indicates the number of empty spaces in the sending buffer. If you do it this way, then if there is no empty space, it will be zero, acting as a false value, causing it to fall into this infinite loop. If there is an empty space, it will be greater than one, so it won't fall into this infinite loop. In this way, you can wait. You can wait and erase. And now that data has been sent from Arduino to PC, you can also send data from PC back to Arduino. To check that, you would use an if statement. Serial value is a command that essentially tells you the actual number of data bytes precisely received from the other side. If there is none, it won't enter this for loop when it's zero. But if it's one or more, it means there are incoming bytes, and it will be inside this for loop. You can read one byte using the kserial library's kserial.read function, and after reading one byte to the microcontroller, use serial.print to send the new value to the serial monitor. I will refer to it as serial.println, which is a function used in programming to print text to the console. By doing it this way, I can input text here in order to achieve the desired result. If you type R here and press enter to send, it will notify you like this. You send up. Right now, the Arduino is currently receiving a character byte A from the PC and then sending it back. When sending this, you can also actually set the format for both print and println. Here, using serial.println.c and DC, you can basically display this value in decimal format and serial.println in hexadecimal format. For instance, you can upload the format value. And for example, I will try writing the uppercase M. If you send the uppercase letter M, it will indicate that you sent the Unicode M and the decimal value, 77, which is 4D. You can send and receive data via serial communication in the following manner. In this session, I first explained how to send and receive data through serial communication. In the next session, I will explain how to perform Arduino debugging using this serial communication. Then, I will see you next time.